Welcome to another video with Howard Piano Industries. In this video, I want to show you how you measure a bass string for duplication. If you have a broken bass string and you need to get one that is exactly like the one you broke, you're going to need to take some measurements. And there's four measurements that you need to supply us with, and I'm going to show you what those are. First of all, you need to measure the length of the copper winding. So this string has been on a piano and can be not very straight. So just in order to straighten it out, clamped it down here so I don't have to hold it straight while I try to measure both. Just using a tape measure, starting at one end of the winding. And so we have a reading of 37 7/16. So that's the first measurement you need to provide us with. The second measurement you need is the distance between the bottom of the hitch pin loop and the start of the winding. So this is coming out at 5 3/8. Two final measurements you need is the diameter of the core of the string, the core being the plain wire part of the string. Does not have the winding on it. Now for this, we use a micrometer. We sell these on our website, but you open it up, the micrometer, I have to get the string in there, and then the little handle here at the end will start to click when it's tight enough. And so a micrometer, it's a little bit tricky to read. It has little lines here. And if you can see, there's the line that is next pointing to the zero, so that's zero. And then there's one other line that's showing there. And if you can see a line completely, it equals 25 thousandths of an inch. So we know there's 25 thousandths of an inch plus whatever else is on the micrometer here. So lining up with this line here. So the mark here is a 14. I know that because the one above it's 15. So I know that this line, which is lining up with the vertical line here, is a 14. So we take 25 plus the 14, it's 39. So 39 is the core measurement, 39 thousandths of an inch. Now we measure the diameter of the core plus the winding. And I'm gonna use the little spindle on the end. When you get it clicking and it stops tightening up, then you know it's where it should be. Okay, this time I'm seeing 1, 2, 3 lines. So 3 times 25 is 75. And now it's the 5 that is lining up with this horizontal line here. So 75 plus 5 is 80. So 80 thousandths of an inch is the diameter of the winding. So given us those four measurements are enough to duplicate the string. If you note that the one measurement we do not need is from the top of the string, the top of the winding here, up to the tuning pin. That is because the string will come with extra length up here and you will cut it to the size you need. So you don't need to worry about that measurement. It will come extra long and you'll cut it down when you get to the piano. So if you have any questions about how to measure a bass string for duplication, I can use the comment section below. And our website is howardpianoindustries.com. And thank you for watching.